This is how that you would install a Wemo light switch without a neutral wire, which of course Wemo said is required, but it is not required.
That's my hair. Not my hair, don't look too crazy. I had to make a new YouTube video. I haven't uploaded in a couple of weeks. I did get to 1,000 subscribers. Thank you. I also am remonetized on YouTube. Shockingly. I honestly didn't think they were gonna approve me. I am back to making some YouTube videos here, and today I have a Wemo light switch. This light switch is compatible with Apple HomeKit. It's compatible with If This Then That. It's compatible with Google Assistant, Alexa. It's compatible with everything. They do make another version of this. That's a three-way light switch. So like if you have one of those lights in your house on your stairs where like you turn it on at the bottom and you can turn it on at the top, that new three-way light switch, which is also $50, can allow you to do that. This one is just for one room. Now some of you know I already have plenty of smart bulbs and plenty of smart devices in my home, and I really needed to get something for my bathroom. And basically that's because there's been many nights that I've told Google to turn off all the lights, and she turns off all the lights, but I left the bathroom light on, and then I have to get up and turn off the bathroom light. Yes, I know it's like 10 feet, but still, I'm already like relaxing in bed. I don't want to get back up again. So this is hopefully going to solve that, and also this will allow other people to go to the bathroom and use the bathroom without having to ask Google to turn on the lights. They'll be able to just hit the switch, turn on the lights, and then of course whenever I'm going to bed I can say all the lights to go off and boom, all of the lights will go off. So let's do a quick unboxing of the Belkin Wemo light switch, and then we're gonna try to do an installation. Now I can say I don't have a neutral wire, but I asked the maintenance man here just yesterday, because he was here actually doing electrical work in my daughter's room, and he said that we did not need the neutral wire, to just run the neutral wire with the ground wire. We're going to find out if that works. So, the Wemo light switch. Turn your lights on and off from anywhere. Of course, you're going to have an app, just like with all the other smart home products. Here on the side, you can apparently set some sunrise and sunset features, which would be nice if you're using this in your bedroom. On and off schedules, and with your phone and, you know, the app, of course, you can control this from anywhere. And on this side, it just gives you a story. And of course, they have other devices. They have a motion device, which when it senses motion, of course, will turn on the lights. And then they also have the plugs, like I have through Genie. Now, to open this, there's just two little pieces of tape right here, which I've already cut. And then on the bottom, this little tab pulls up. And then it opens like so. Like so. Welcome to Wemo. And then here is, this looks like your little instruction guide with your information on how to install this. I am not an electrician at all, but I'm going to give this a go. So for once, I'm going to hold on to instructions and not just throw them to the side like I normally do. Inside here, we have the plate. If you notice, the plate does not have any holes in it because it just clips into place on here. Right into these. If you look on the bottom here, that is where that the plate will clip into place on the switch. And this is the light switch itself. There's four wires back here. Two wires for your switch, a neutral wire, and the ground wire. And these are just little caps. You put these in here, and then when you twist it, I don't know what these are called, but that's what those are. And that's all that's in the bottom here, besides information from users and, of course, your general FCC statement.
So here's a little close-up look of it. Oh, it even says Belkin there. Nice. Love that sound. Here's a closer view of the actual light switch, the model number. Hold the reset button for 5 seconds. There's your wires and everything. I mean, it's pretty simple. There's not a whole lot to this other than just actually knowing how to wire this in properly and not kill yourself. But this will essentially just clip right in, and that's what the light switch will look like once it's on my wall. So let's go do this. Alright, let's see. Any, mini, money, mo?
Did I actually get that on the first try? Holy crap.
This was the first one that I flipped, so that's on.
I have a restroom light.
Nice! So somehow, as you can see, none of this is labeled, and I just happened to pick the right switch. Small bummer, I plan to use this outlet to have a light, but apparently that outlet is tied to the restroom as well. There we go, now we have some light. Had to go in my complete mess of cables there, but I need a light to be able to do this. And now I just gotta find a spot to put it on the wall. There we go, that should do the trick. Alright, so let's see if this is an epic failure like that was. This is an epic failure on my behalf, or if it actually works. Old. Very old. Alright, let's see. Now we take out this screw. Alright, now this should pull out like so. And these do look like the switch wires, considering that they're right there where the switch is. So, as I've mentioned, I know nothing about electrical, but from what he told me yesterday, switch wire, neutral wire, ground wire, the ground and the neutral will go together to go to right here for the ground wire, and then here's my switch wires, which will go into these.
30 years.
Alright, so now that I have the light switch out, I'm not going to be filming the rest of this. It's just way too complicated to try to film and do this. But, as I mentioned, my ground and my neutral are going to go to this wire, which is the ground. And then the switch wires, which are right there, will plug into these. So, yeah, let's do this. Alright, and that's essentially what it looks like. Now, what I just realized after I did all this is I don't have a lot of room in here, and this is pretty big. I don't know if this is going to work size fitting wise, but we'll find out in a second. So, no sparks, no explosions. I have a flashing green light. So let me see what that actually means to see if this is working correctly or whatnot.
So as I'm editing this, I realized that the files that I screen recorded from my phone did not work. So basically though, to just install it on the phone once you have it hooked up in the wall, it's very simple. Download the Wemo app, follow the instructions on the screen, you should be able to do it. Sadly, my screen record did not work. Sorry about that, but again, the app will tell you every single thing to do. So I'm fairly certain that you can knock that out.
So it is working. The light is now blue, and when I press it, bada bing, power in the restroom. Now I gotta get this set up to my Google Assistant, but also I gotta see if I can get all this to fit back in here. So before I do that, I'm gonna go cut the breaker again, because I don't want to be touching these wires and stuff with the breaker live. Mush them together. I can't do this with the camera. Sorry, people. It must take it a moment to boot. Something else that I've learned, this wall was unfortunately very thin just due to how this is designed. If you see here, you know, like right there's my computer and stuff, like the wall's just not very thick. That has resulted in this sticking out, which I'm not going to be here that much longer, so I really don't care. And also there's no like electrical stuff here, so it's not, I'm not going to get shocked or anything like that. Now, let's go grab the plate for this, so kind of angle at the top, and then it should clip at the bottom. Oh, there we go. Bingo! Now it's in there. And there is lights. Let me turn this off. So, lights are on, you can see my mess, and bingo, off on. I love it. I did it. I'm shocked, but I did it. And so that is it. I'm a little surprised at myself that I was actually able to do it. Bummed about how it sticks out. Nothing I can really do there. But this is how that you would install a Wemo light switch without a neutral wire, which of course Wemo said is required, but it is not required. And it works now. Hey, turn off the bathroom lights. There we go. And there's also always this nice little light so you can see the light switch. That is awesome. Hey, go turn on all the lights. And there we go. Sure. Turning on 11 lights. So it knows it's a light. It is working exactly how that it was supposed to. I'm kind of surprised that I got it to install and do everything, but I'm very happy with myself. I feel proud. And so there you have it, with my laundry in the back and all. That is how that you would install a Wemo light switch without the neutral wire. As you can see, it is working. I ran the neutral and the ground together to the ground and then ran the switch wires and boom. I was easily able to add it into my Google Assistant. Wemo does not have you actually make an account. It goes by your Wi-Fi settings, which is really kind of weird. I didn't make a Wemo account. It did ask for my email though. But I thought I'd make an actual account where I signed in like I did with Genie and some of the other apps with Philips. I didn't have to, so I'm not really complaining. It's just weird. Like, I guess if I change my Wi-Fi name, what's going to happen then? It won't verify because it verified through Wi-Fi. Either way, that's to worry about at another time. This is the Wemo light switch unboxing, setup, and review without the neutral wire. And it seems to be working exactly as it should. I can tell Google to turn off all the lights. The bathroom lights go off. If I say turn on all the lights, the bathroom lights come on. And if I just tell the bathroom lights to turn on or off, they turn on or off. And also the button works as well. So this thing works exactly how it's advertised. They do have a new three-way switch that just came out. That's, like I said, the one for like if you have stairs and stuff in your house. So that's pretty cool. And yeah, I think that's gonna do it for this video. Hopefully you enjoyed it. Hopefully you learned something. I learned a lot. That's my first time ever doing anything electrical at all. Like, at all. Other than, like, with a computer, but that don't really count. So, but I will see you all in the next one. My hair's gotten kind of crazy now that I've been all moving around and stuff. I hope you have a good one. Click the like button. Click the subscribe down in the corner. And we will see you in the next one. Deuces.